Oh, it was last Saturday.
Okay.
What did you do last Saturday?
Lagunitas.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. That's, I'm sure that's such a fun gig.
Well, that was during the time I was isolating. That's right. I didn't get sick.
How long were you sick for, do you think?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, it kind of trickled out just like around 5 days a week. The first couple days were the worst, but.
My brother's been sick for over 2 weeks. Well, 2 weeks.
Yeah, that's really long.
And he's.
COVID?
Yeah, COVID positive, and he's miserable.
Right now?
Yeah.
Where's he at?
This is across the lake, Kenmore. Wow. But yeah, he's.
Vaccinated.
Doctor, they vaccinated. He got an X-ray, and there's a little worry area in his lungs right now. So as long as he doesn't get worse, he probably will be all right. But if he gets worse, he's gonna have to get worked up.
1 minute.
I'm glad you didn't get super sick. Yeah, I had it 2 years ago in March, and I was about 5 days. It got better as
well. Wow, right at the beginning.
It hit. Yeah, it hit. Right away, I mean, I went from going to work, being at home, and in the course of like 2-3 hours, I started going, and then I went to bed, and it was just all over. Right. Yeah, but yeah, by Saturday, I was like Monday to Saturday, Monday to Friday. Let's make sure we record this time, too.
Sure, okay, well, what, can you check here, I'll do YouTube. I don't, if you can do Twitch, because I have my new phone doesn't have it all set up. Norman Baker's life.
No,
okay, if you can check Twitch, I got this.
still see wrong, right? Yeah, babe. Cause I've got my mama's eyes. Yeah, I've got my mama's eyes.
That's a Justin Towns Earl song. Nashville singer songwriter, son of Steve Earl, who unfortunately passed away summer before last.
Did they do that?
At the exact same age as me.
Did they do that tribute for him already? You know, they're.
Oh, I don't know.
Some all star tribute they're doing.
A show? Or a
yeah, like a tribute to just everybody, you know.
I
like,
know
I'll get back to you.
I bet they did.
Yeah.
I know his dad, Steve Earl, single music video coming out for this one. It's called Broken Stone. Thank you.
reminisce about a girl I miss. Yeah, I got a solution. I'm heading her way. I'm heading her way. I'm heading her way. I'm heading her way. Well, shot the video at like one of my oldest best friend's farm down in Auburn.
That place with the pond?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you can.
It's a beautiful place down in Auburn. Auburn Green Valley Road. Probably the Flaming Geyser. I don't know if you've been down there, but it's a very, very beautiful area. It's like kind of on the, like, kind of near like Utah, Maple Valley.
And you played there a couple times last summer, right?
We did do a farm concert down
there.
Yeah,
I remember that. Hmm.
Yeah, that was one of the last concerts of the summer. It was a farm concert, which we'll be doing down there annually.
Nice.
This last year was the first time we did it, and it was a success. And so we're going to figure it out and build it out from there. Next summer we'll be doing another farm concert down there.
Nice. Stand by the farm.
Yeah, totally. I mean... from Kent, it's like I play basically in every town in Washington except Kent. There's nowhere to play in Kent, Auburn area or anything. Which is kind of understandable, but whatever, you know. I have a love-hate relationship with where I'm from. And but yeah, it's
the heart of Kent is right in you.
Is it? Singer out of Kent, but you can't take Kent out of the folk singer. Something like that.
One of our regulars says there's good mushroom picking on those farms in Auburn.
Oh yeah, Lake Braden. Yeah, there is some good mushroom picking out there. You're right. How'd you know that?
He's one of our star.
Here's one I wrote in a living room in West Seattle about 7 years ago. This one's called Leon Redbone Blue. Third world tastes better on an empty tummy. Entertain. met in the first world, numbing down. Going to see Leon Bridges, he's playing and the show is packed. I'm holding up the wall way in the back. Song about Kent. It's also kind of about Seattle and basically anywhere where there's rapid changes coming on that are hard to keep up with. That's the Cliff Notes version, but the song kind of talks about a lot of things, like most of my songs. This is Where Did the Land Go? Put out a single a couple years ago, this one with my band Norman Baker in the Back Roads. Wherever you're tell you straight up all along, the fire in the Benjamin Brothers heart, making a living, telling truth in a song. Oh, oh, all up in the mustard, trying to catch up. Too many cooks in the kitchen, it's such a drain. Sipping on Kool-Aid, we don't know the flavor. Oh, oh.
Thank you.
Sounds so lovely. Is Norman Baker in the backrooms on Spotify?
Norman Baker in the backrooms are on Spotify. I joined the dark side a long time ago. I know they've been in the news a lot lately, too. And I'm in no position right now to debate.
Yeah.
I've got a show to play.
So you have
we can talk about the struggles of the music industry.
Speaking of, don't forget to tip this gentleman.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Thanks for reminding
yes.
me, Amika. That
yeah. It's pinned up there.
Hit up
in
my Venmo
and
PayPal and send some donations. This
exactly.
is a donation-only, digital tip-only type of online performance. And thanks to Amika for having me and Fiddler Zoom for making this whole thing happen. And Doug helping out behind the scenes.
Yes. Speaking of Spotify, do you know any Neil Young?
Yeah.
Maybe there's some.
Yeah, yes, good question.
Maybe there's some.
We'll play some Neil Young at some point.
Okay.
Not right this second,
yeah.
but we will.
Alright. That's where I was going
that's
with
a great
Spotify.
Idea.
A little segue out of the Spotify.
That's a great
out of the
idea.
Spotlight. The Spotify Spotlight.
I think it's time for a Tom Waits song.
Ooh.
I have a side project called Boogie Baker Band. It's kind of based around old school New Orleans R&B style music, 60s-ish. And but we do a little bit of everything, and I, for that band, I rearranged a Tom Waits song. His first song on his first album called Old 55, and made it into an entirely different group of people. And we're gonna do that for you.
Coming up, I'm riding.
cover in Boogie or the Boogie Baker Band. Boogie Baker?
What?
Oh, who else do you cover? You said you're kind of fit. Yeah.
Oh, it's...
all these New Orleans artists.
Well, basically, like, Lee Dorsey.
Yeah.
Is basically my favorite artist. I mean, it's some of my favorite music of all time.
That's
like, 60s, early 70s. Lee Dorsey's got, like, a couple of some of my favorite albums of all time. Produced and arranged and written. Most of his songs are written by Alan Toussaint, who's also his producer and arranger. He's one of the most iconic New Orleans musicians and producers of all time. And the backing band is the Meters for those early recordings. And I mean,
I won't miss it next time.
A winning combination.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's just some of the funkiest music. Definitely huge inspiration, and so that's kind of like what inspired me to like start to do this side project.
Cool.
Boogie Baker Band. But we also cover Oludara. Oludara, he used to play in Art Blakey's band back in the day. He used to play trumpet, cornet, in Art Blakey's band, but then he was really in the blues and like fast forward several decades from when he played with Art Blakey. He put out two albums on Blue Note Records in 1999 and 2001 that were really amazing, but he doesn't really like the music industry, and you know, everyone and the label and everyone wanted to put out more albums, but he's just like, nah, I'm good. I don't really like the music industry.
Yeah.
But Oludara's two albums, they're so good. And he's also Nas's dad, the rapper, most iconic and successful rappers. Nas, like a lot of people don't know that his dad's a blues singer-songwriter and retired jazz trumpet cornet player. But yeah, so we do some of that. We do some Beatles. We do some. Deep cuts. Like we do Brenton Wood. Brenton Wood is this other like soul R&B artist from the 60s, 70s. He just had like a couple albums, not many people really know about him. And then like Ernie K. Doe, another 60s New Orleans R&B singer that was produced and arranged by Alan and written, all his songs were written by Alan Toussaint as well. But yeah, that band does a lot of fun stuff. It's a unique kind of group. Here's one I wrote in New Braunfels, Texas, a couple years ago in the backyard of my friend's permaculture farm. This is inspired by, it's one of my songs about music. A song inspired by one of my favorite scene drummers, which is Levon Helm. This song is Levon, the Singing Drummer. Singing drummer, Players all gotta get real jobs. They can't come on the road to leave. Won't you come on now? Don't make them draw from a straw. Know you're all and filled with what you got. Don't become a stranger, cause then I won't know. Like real good music and the radio. Like good, good music and the radio. Whoa. Where did you go?
Do lyrics first, or
and I throughout the process of writing the song, I realize what it's about. And sometimes at the end, I go, "Oh, yeah, that's what it's about." Yeah. Just because I wrote it doesn't mean I knew what it was all about during the process. But yeah, you asked if I do lyrics first or whatever.
Yeah, lyrics.
That's like, yeah, lyrics. A lot of people ask things like that. Like, do you lyrics first or the chords first or whatever or melody first? And, for me, it's different for every song. It just really depends. Like, sometimes I'll have a process that, like, works for a while. Time I'm in a creative mood writing session and end up being something totally different. So I don't really try to like stay attached to a certain process in terms of writing and composing. My creative spouts of creativity when I'm in creative moods, it's not always in that mindset.
It's so, driven from different places.
Yeah, yeah, like sometimes I don't write a song for 6 months and then I'll like write two, three songs in a day. And then the next day I'll write three or four more. Pretty ADD, so like if I'm in a creative mood and I'm like starting working on a song, I'll get like, you know, for example, maybe I'll get like a verse and a chorus and then I'll like get stuck. But I'm still like in a creative mood and so I'll just like go to an entirely different place. With like a different song, different chords, riff, and I'll like start writing an entirely different song, and then I'll get stuck on that, and I'll go back to the first one, and like, so there's a good chunk of my tunes are like, they came two at a time. A lot of my songs, like this song I wrote, and I
basically the same time as this other tomb.
And you find
and they're not. They're not anywhere near this. They're not the same at all. But everyone has a different process. I don't try to like stay attached to a certain process or anything.
Yeah.
But you know, I also play bass with a lot of different people in different bands. And,
you're always busy.
And just like that's like being a musician as opposed to being a songwriter like we're doing right now. It's very, very different things. So in terms of being a bass player playing.
You're in high demand, no. It's always keeping busy. Good. It's very lucky to have you.
I hope so. It's an interesting, fun life.
Yeah.
What should we play next?
Yes.
Speaking of interesting, fun life.
I want
a Neil Young song.
Sure.
Hmm.
Maybe should we have any requests out there?
Which Neil Young song?
There's several.
Let me take a sip of wine and ponder this.
Well, you know the one that you inspired me to learn, but.
Which one? Cortez? Heart of Gold?
Unknown
Legend?
Yeah.
Yeah,
but the other ones are great too. whatever you want.
Let's do Unknown Legend.
Ooh, Tonight's the Night. So let's play Tonight's the Night too. Yeah.
That's I can't do Tonight's the Night.
No. I heard you do that.
Too much spoken word in that song. I don't do spoken word.
Oh.
No one wants to hear me talk. Here I am, right in my mouth between songs.
I know. This is like our interview session.
Running your mouth is different than spoken word. But yeah, I don't do the spoken word. That whole album, that's one of my favorite Neil Young albums, that Tonight's the Night album. But yeah, let's do the one that you're talking about learning. This is,
I should be sitting in.
Unknown Legend from one of his albums from the 90s.
Harley Davidson.
Oh, there's a long list now?
Heart of gold, the free world, winter long.
Winter long, ooh, that's a good one.
You could
see
Nicole.
I might do winter long someday, but not tonight.
Thank you for doing that.
Yeah, next time. don't mind me just pulling up some lyrics real quick.
Do you need a shot more of that?
Oh, sure. Thank you. They take care of you real good here at the Fiddler's Inn. Very much looking forward to them being fully open. Very cool, rare place doing live music every Monday. And they got a new patio out front. There's more outdoor seating now, so when stuff gets and it's heated, and when stuff gets back to normal or slightly closer to normal, not that anyone ever knew what normal was in the first place. Thank you. Because otherwise I'd be normal. I guess. Let's pick up the pace a little bit. I'm going to do one of my favorite Kinks songs. Kinks are one of my favorite bands. And if you don't know the Kinks, then you're weird. You better get to know the damn Kinks. Okay. That's best band of all time. It is time for you to stop all of your sobbing.
He is 21. He just turned 3, so he's 21 and dog years.
Depends on the size, right? Yeah. The breed, right?
Yeah.
But.
Oh, he was coming.
Fine. We'll feed him alcohol. No, we won't.
We're that kind of place.
No, that's a bad matchup.
We're like, oh, we could go on all night with the requests. Get some people loving your variety.
I'm working on a song called Bad Requests.
Bad Requests?
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
Because definitely get a lot of those.
Okay.
Over the centuries.
Is that a for real thing, or is that a new thing?
What?
Is that really true?
It's true,
you are?
Yeah.
Okay.
The song is like almost done.
Oh.
I'm going to do another Justin Towns Earl song. If I may.
Yes, I remember you playing
and I saw you out in Port Townsend a number of years ago at that place that was like past Port Townsend, the something depot or the what was that place that was really funky?
Oh,
it was like a brewery slash like horseshoe something.
The tiny little spot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was like a brewery or
Disco Bay Detour.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Or Discovery Bay.
Yeah, Discovery Bay.
Wow. No, that place it's closed. They're not there anymore.
It's
a fun little spot.
It is. I remember you playing.
I like playing in those small towns, like the the one venue in like the small town. Those are like some of my favorite gigs.
Ooh. Speaking of, I'm going to hook you up with my friends at Twist River.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Pub.
Well, hopefully I'll be out there again soon. I actually just messaged it back the other day.
Hmm.
But yeah, speaking of like Olympic Peninsula, I'll be out there this weekend. Me and Michael, my right-hand man, we're playing Saturday Tracy Public House and Sunday afternoon in Chimicum, right next to Port Townsend.
Yeah.
At Finn River Farms.
Nice.
It's one of the most beautiful parts of Washington in general, so it's hard to do that. But we're playing Finn River Farms is a beautiful setting.
Cool.
Family, like afternoon, Sunday afternoon.
Nice.
All ages.
And then you can go hit up Tomahawk.
Yard games and hard cider and food trucks.
Sounds lovely in the summertime.
Yeah, well, it is an outdoor stage, but it's like enclosed.
Mm-hmm.
They have the option to like enclose it
tent.
With like whatever the plastic or tent, like these makeshift windows. And it is very actually cozy. That music year round, it's like you're still kind of outdoor, but it's still totally cozy. Like it's
cool.
It's a pretty unique thing, you know. You don't really about outdoor gigs in the winter, but
we're
works.
In the Pacific Northwest, we've made this happen.
They do it.
Not everywhere is doing outdoor seating all year round. We have to toughen up to keep our livelihood going.
It's funny how I've been in Seattle. It's hard. What would I know about that?
I know, you're from Kent. You're from Kent.
Right, but it's more of a Seattleite than a lot of people that live, than most people that live in this region. That's another discussion for another time. Got music to play.
Yes.
Here's another Justin Townes Earl song. Start looking west, but tonight
you did something to me.
I never performed that. It's the first time I ever.
Oh, wow.
Very good. Thank you.
Jackson really liked it, too. That him old jam, too. You see?
Who did?
Oh, sure. He did a little. He did a little. Yelp after, right after you finished that song, he went,
oh. Oh, oh yeah, yeah.
He liked it, too.
Yeah. I don't know if you can see the dog right here, but he's cuddling up with my knee. My knee and my phone.
He likes that. He likes your music.
Better than... I'm trying to do a concert here.
Stealing the show. He likes the camera.
Yeah. Here's one of my COVID induced songs. I wrote in a log cabin in Leavenworth while sheltering in place at the very beginning of lockdown with a canceled tour. I was on tour when lockdown started. I had to turn around. Instead of coming back here to the epicenter at the time of coronavirus, I went to a log cabin in Leavenworth for 2 weeks in sheltered in place. Instead of playing every night for a month and a half everywhere between here and New Orleans, I just wrote songs and kicked it with my portable studio that I had with me. This log cabin, this song came out of that. It's about selling baseball cards when I was 5 years old at the end of my driveway. And many other things about the neighborhood. It's called The Kid Down the Road. Sale. Oh, well.
They'd fight for my affection. I didn't take offense, because Whitney always won, until along came Mariah and a mermaid named Ariel. I'm still holding my breath. We'd swim through the night, new secrets in my dreams. Sweet, sweet fantasy, baby.
Boxes you move from house to house. You know, you never unload the boxes, but you're like, oh, these boxes,
song,
I have to.
There's a song in there, so.
Yes.
Two or three songs.
Yeah.
How late's the show going tonight?
Whenever you want.
Late,
it's 8:08. I mean, whatever you want, yeah. If you're feeling good.
8:08. Okay.
8:08. That's Hawaii's area code.
It's also a really. Really good kick drum.
Oh.
Sound.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, very nice.
Very prominent in 80s rap.
Oh.
808. I've been enjoying playing other people's songs.
Yeah.
That
I missed it last Saturday. That's right up my alley.
I don't need nobody but fish to koi.
An old soul. Well, he's.
There was
he's,
a while I was worried about the future of music.
Well, there's a reason why he's good though, because he sounds. He has an old soul sound.
Exactly.
Like, so good.
That's why he showed up in one of the songs I wrote that I sang earlier, like one of my songs about music. And Jerry, I played bass and back vocals. The old school reggae legend, Jamaican legend, Winston Jerry. I played tour with him for about 8 years. And one of the songs that he did is called Ain't That Lovin' You. So, which was, in Jamaica, it was covered by a lot of people, Alton Ellis. Jarrett was Alton Ellis and the Flames, and Winston Jarrett was Alton Ellis' background vocalist. He was one of the Flames. And, but then embarked on his own career, and then when he moved here, I ended up playing bass for a long time. This is one of the songs that I learned from playing with him. I assumed it was a Alton Ellis original. Soul, American soul singer wrote it. But anyway, I'm gonna play it for you. It's my rendition of Winston Jarrett's rendition of Paul Allison's rendition of Ain't That Lovin' You. I think it's Stax Records. I think it was originally Stax Records. Better get my facts straight before I start talking about it.
We're in the era of getting your facts straight.
You know, maybe someone will comment who
yes.
wrote.
Charles?
Who wrote Ain't That Lovin' You?
Come on, Charles. Welcome to
thank you. that pulls other men's sled. But I love the way you carry yourself. I even love the way you wear your hair. Ain't that loving you? Ain't that loving you? No. Ain't that loving you? For more reasons than one. Did it ever occur to you why I do all any man can do? You keep a smile on your face. Cause I love you, I love you, I love you so many ways.
We'll do a couple more.
Yeah. Two more.
Before we call it an evening.
Yeah.
Remember set lists? I don't remember set lists.
Yeah, nice to kind of just go with your feeling, what you're feeling though, right?
Exactly. It is Monday, after all.
Being in a tiny little ball. He's really enjoying your tunes.
Who is?
Shucks.